Today we are going to discuss about the computer graphics. All problems in computer graphic can be solved with the matrix inversion. In this code, I'm going to start what is a computer graphics. In that, we are going to be detailed. We are going to be discuss about the CRT. CRT is nothing but cathode ray tube. In the traditional manner, if you want to be display a single dot upon the in your screen, we need to use CRT. What is a CRT? The CRT is a primary output device in graphics, that is nothing but video monitoring. Computer graphics is a creation of picture with the help of the computer. The end product may be, it may be anything. It may be the business graphics, drawing, or engineering, means anything. It may be anything. But in the computer graphic, we can use two or three dimension picture. It depends on how we require. There are two kinds of computer graphics. One we will call as a raster, one we will call as a vector. The raster we will call as a composed of pixel, means the raster image are more commonly called bitmap images. A bitmap images use a grid of individual pixel where each pixel can be different color and shadow. In the computer graphic, especially in the CRT, pixel play very significant role. With the help of the pixel, we are going to striking our dot, means anything if you want to be displayed in the traditional manner, the CRT is play very, very significant role to give a output. So now we'll go for cathode ray tube. So in this video, we are going to be discuss, we are going to be detailly, we are going to be display about the cathode ray tube. What it is? Means it is a technology that is used widely in the traditional televisions and screen. How it is going to be? An image is created on the screen on cathode ray tube. That image is formed by firing electrons. It's firing electron from the backside of the tube with help of the phosphorus, which is located towards the screen on CRT. It accelerates and deflects the electron beam on the screen to create the images. Here we have, when you are using the CRT, we are going to be use the three main, means actually the two means the CRT is actually going to do modulates, accelerate, and defills. So it is very, very important. Defaults means it is very important to know that these three things are it is going to be doing. So now we will get into how CRT is working. We will see each part how it is be working. This topic is very, very important. CRT is a very, very important. So in this slide, we are going to discuss CRT construction and working. CRT means cathode ray tube, means it is specialized in vacuum tube. So you can see it is look like a vacuum tube. So you can see in this, that is a screen, it's look like a vacuum tube. Okay. So the image is produced when the electron beam strike the phosphorus in the surprise, means it should be. So it is very important if you want to get a single spot on your screen. So we'll go left side. First, we will discuss about the left side. So first we will discuss about the left side. So you can see in the left side, we have a pins, okay, and heater, and we have a base, and we have a cathode. This all means we will call as a gun. Okay. So this gun is going to be, means it is gun is only, it's very, very important. This gun is consisting, means the gun is going to do heating the filament with the help of, with the help of cathode, means it is going to be striking, it is going to be producing, eating filament. Okay, so it is very, very important, means with the help of this GaN only, we are going to be striking out the light, means we are going to get the striking on the light. So this cathode, what this cathode is going to do, it is generates a negatively charged electrons. They spin and base. This is the one we will call as a gun. This gun, it is going to create, means it is going to be produced, or we can say it is going to be generate the electron, means generate the heat, heat fragment. It is going to generate the heat fragment. But in this cathode, with the help of this cathode, it generates negatively charged electrons. So it is combination, it is going to be produced the heat fragment. So once the heat fragment, it is strike. Okay. So this is the one. Next, we can see as a control grid. We will call as a control grid. What this control grid, what this control grid is going to do? This control grid going to be flow the, means it is going to be control the flow of whatever the striking the heat, it is going to be controlled. Means you can see that it is coming striking, means it should not spread here and there. So this control grid is going to be controlled. It has to strike correctly with the prosper, with the screen. So it is going to be controlled, means so that the electron flow freely. So this is very, very important. Next, we are going for the focusing. Next point, we are going to discuss about the focusing node. What this focusing node going to do? It is going to be create whatever the image it is displaying upon the screen, it should be clear. It should not be blur. So if in your image, any screen, means whatever it is produced, whatever it is displayed, it may be it is not clear, then we have a problem in the focusing node. So the focusing node is going to take a role in the CRT. That is, it is going to see that whatever you're striking, whatever your output you're giving, it should be clear. It should not be blur. So this is the focusing node work is going to see that, create a clear picture by focusing the electron into narrow beam. So we are getting as a narrow, striking the things, I mean striking that gun, that we are producing the heat. Okay, when you're producing heat, it generates with the help of cathode, it is generates the negatively charged electrons, so that the focusing node is going to give a clear picture. Okay, so now when you're coming for the when you're coming for the next point, before I'm going for the accelerating node, that before that I'm going to be explain about the vertical deflection plate and horizontal deflection plate. It is very, very important. So you're going to get how you're going to be, means this is the one, it's very, very important. In these two things, we are going to be deal with electron and magnetic field. These two is very important. Means it is a deflection is nothing, but it is going to give direction of the control. Means it has to horizontally, it has to be display, or it has to be vertically, has to be display. It is going to be, this plate is going to be take a place, means it is going to play significant role in that. Means the whatever the electrons, the beam is coming through the focusing system, means focusing with the help of focusing node, it has to be identified. It should be vertically or it should be horizontally. So when you are speaking about the deflections, so I told you the deflection is nothing but the direction of the control. So when, if you're taking as a electrons, so when you're going for electric, we have a two pair of parallel pits are used for the horizontally and vertically. But when you're coming for the vertically, you are using, means when you say about the magnetic, when you're using as a magnetic, we will call as a coil, for one for the horizontal and another for the vertical. So the same way the control grid, same way this accelerating node also is working, but when it is moving, see, when accelerative and unit, most of the time we can say it is in the vertical deflections because it has to go for the up and down in the screen. It has to be print up and down the screen that each pixel. So this vertical deflection and horizontal deflection is very, very important. Okay, so next we are going for the last one, that is we will call as a prosperous screens. So in that outer part, when you see that, we won't see anything. It is a normal screen. But inside that, when you see that screen inside, we have a we will call as means we have a coated, prosperous coated. Prosperous will be there. The prosperous nothing but it is going to be glow, means that is a glow, means what is going to happen, the glow highly energy, means when you taking, when you, the gun is striking out in the narrow, it is striking, that energy is fall upon the prosperous coat, and that coat strike the your backside, means that screen backside, the prosperous coat, it is strike and it is going to be going to get a dot, means it is going to be spot out. So the prosperous coat is very, very important. The strike energy means when it's striking, the gun is striking that the beam in the narrow, it fall upon the prosperous coat. Through that prosperous coat, when he strike, in that whatever the glow it is there, it is going to be fall. So here today, what I explained here, it is only for black and white. Okay, so when you're going for the color, we have a three type of the gun. Okay, so here we have only the one gun, through that we are going to get as a black and white. Depends on how you are going to be striking. But when you are going for the color monitor, the color monitor, we have three type of gun, that is red, green, blue, three type of the gun, the combinations of that striking, we are going to get the output. So now see, this is the CRT monitor. Okay, so in the CRT monitor, you can see that is a very traditional manner, means traditional manner we are use this CRT monitor. What is that? The CRT, the main points, the conclusions, you have to keep it in your mind what it is each point, because this question is very, very important. In this question, compulsory CRT function is very important question in a point of your exam. CRT is nothing but cathode ray tube electron gun, means what is electron guns? I told you that beginning we have electrons guns, emits the electron beam, emits, it is going to be striking or it is going to be emits electron beam. Focusing system coverage, electron beam to small spot when it strike to prosperous coating. When it is striking the prosperous coating, it is going to be spot, means the small part you are going to be. The keep on it is be spotting so that you are going to get the image. So vertical and horizontal deflection system control the movement of beam in the horizontal or it may be directional, vertical directions. The prosperous coating create bright spot when the electron beam strike on it. So this is the one we are going to be CRT. It's a very, very important that it is very, very important. So once again, I will repeat. So first one, you have to remember the CRT. What is a CRT? It is nothing but cathode ray tube. Next, you have to remember the gun. Okay, the gun is going to be emit the electron beam. So this is a point. Just you can remember with the diagram. Just in next one will be electron guns. That is emits the electron beam. Third one, focusing system coverage, means if you want to be, means the focusing, means you can say the control, focusing control. So focusing is very, very important. So depends on your focusing only we come to know your picture is clear or not. Okay, so the coverage, electron beam to small part when it is strike to prosperous coating. Next one, you have to remember vertical and horizontal deflection system control movement of the beam in horizontal or vertical direction. Next, we will go for the prosperous coating create bright spot when electron beam strike on the upon the phosphorus. So you're going to get the One small dot, okay? So again, once again, I will repeat the things. This is the one what I explained in the black and white output. When you're going for the color, you have to remember three guns. Through that three guns, we are going to get the color monitors. I hope this one, if you means you got the idea, so that you keep it, this is in your mind. That is what all you have to remember. Thank you.